Howdy, folks. It's me, Manic Merc, coming to you from the bunker system with Friday record finds. Anyway, record finds. Let's get right to it. Wait a minute. Let's tell a story first. So I'm in the Goodwill, and I'm looking through records, and they put some out. And then this guy comes back with the store manager after I've gone through the three large bins. I don't know what he was doing. But he had been through them, and he'd taken some records up front, and he came back, and he looks at me, and he says, "Did you see any records sitting out on top?" And I said, "Well, no, I don't remember. I don't think so." And he says, "Well, we're looking for a record that was filled with bed bugs." I'm like, "Ah!" You know, I'm like, "I don't know." And the manager's like, "We've never had a problem here. They check us once a month. We've never had a problem." And I said, "I don't know. I didn't see anything. I've got holding these records in my hand, you know, and I've been leaning up against them." And then he starts flipping through everything. And I said, "Well, what was the record?" "I don't remember." I said, "Was it a gatefold?" "Don't remember." "What bin was it on?" "Don't remember." So I let him look through my records. Like, I said, "Well, could you see them?" "Yeah, you just pull the record out, they're all over it." So I take my records up, and he comes up, and I just wanted to say, "Crazy record collectors, they're all nuts!" So I take my records up front, he comes up, and his records are up there, and he's going through all of them, and he pulls, "Oh, here it is! He had the record with the bugs in it, in his stack, up front!" And I look at it, it looks like, I don't know how, it's like full of gnats or something, like dead gnats. Nothing was alive in the... Anyway. That was tense. I got a real nice bin there, plastic bin to put records in. While I was there. Anyway. I'm going to go through the records. Now you're probably like itching. "Ew, don't touch them. I'm itching." No, they weren't. They didn't have the thing. It was some other kind of insect that was in the damn thing at one time. They were all like skeletal, dehydrated bugs. I don't know what the hell. Anyway, it was weird. And I just like to say the people that come into record stores are funny. There are not that many records, so it's not going to take that much time, okay? And you can scroll through and watch me hold the first one or whatever you want. Anyway, I'm into one record store and a guy comes in. He's very polite. And he said, would you have a moment just to look at some records that I brought in?" And the guy, my favorite guy, Mike, he's like over 70. He's still living off the grid in the middle of the city and running this record store. It's really quite a fabulous story right there. He pulls out some 45s, and Mike says, "Well, I really don't know much that much about 45s. And, "Well, what about this and about that?" Mike says, "Yeah, I don't know." He goes, "Well, I just wondered if you could maybe take a moment and I can come back and maybe you could research these for me." Mike's like, "Well, my computer broke about 6 months ago. I don't care about it anymore. How I price records, people bring them in, I give them money, and I you know, add on some money. He doesn't give crap." I can't believe somebody would impose themselves on a store owner to research their records for them. That blew my mind anyway. But he hadn't had a customer. I was his first customer in 2 days. I felt really bad for him. I don't know what the deal is. And the other guy, my friend Mike, is like, "I've been sitting here forever, like a day. Nobody." So I don't know what the deal is with people are just not buying records. So I helped them both out, because I'm just the kind of nice guy that I am. The first record I'm going to hold up is on some kind of obscure label, Shelby S. Singleton. I think it's just some guy that wanted to produce a record for these people. It's private press, SSS International. It's, I think, a soul record. It's a split record between a woman named Peggy Scott and a guy named Jojo Benson. Well, they look like they know each other. He's wearing fabulous purple shoes. 1974, is Hamilton Bohannon? Foot stomp and music, East Coast groove, disco stomp. Dankar Records, Brunswick, must have just manufactured it. Comic book record, House of Terror. It's got a comic book on the inside of it. It's got the whole story. Stanley Black picked up another one of his. Early records on London. There's a bunch of great tunes on this. Saboni, Jungle Drums. Nice cover. Late 50s, I'm sure. This looks like great fun. Henry Mancini, Arabesque. The soundtrack for a movie, Arabesque. I've never seen it. But you know there's got to be some fun 60s stuff on this. You just know there has to be. Gogi Grant, Torch Time. Who was it that turned me on to Gogi? Was that Sal? Sal, is that you? Lovely photograph. Torch songs, looking forward to listening to that. Don't know who Howard Roberts is. I like the graphic. There he is. All the cigarette butts on the floor. He's playing guitar. Collar him funky like a coloring book. My friend Mark had this record, and every time I go visit him, I say, do you want to keep that record? Now I don't have to beat him up anymore, Mark. Because, look, ha-ha, I've got my own copy now. Ooh, I got to take off the sticker. I didn't manage to take the sticker off of everything. This was a fun find and a deal. Marvel Comic Group record. I have no idea. A word to parents and teachers about this comic book and record set. Was there supposed to be a comic book inside this? Marvel Spectacular Comics comes to life. It's Captain America and the Adventures. I just like this cover because of the group of people in the living room eating hors d'oeuvres and having a glass of wine, wearing their suits and fancy dresses. Swanee River Boogie, Stranger in Paradise, Jezebel, Winfred Atwell at the piano. I got a Doors album, The Soft Parade. For a dollar, I figured it was worth it. It's really clean. And this one looked like great fun. Go Places with Lassie. I had a weird... See, there's a woman right here. The song titles are cool. Brazil, there's a cover of Brazil. April in Portugal. Japanese Sandman, Hawaiian War Chant, Song of India. Those are some great song titles. Oh, Lassie Coats. It's Coats. It's a manufacturer of Coats. Fashion. Okay. Isn't that interesting? And Avedon. Avedon, not that guy. Not Avedon. Maybe it is Avedon. Avedon? Richard Avedon? He's a famous photographer, ain't he? I could research these before I actually sit down and do this presentation, but then it would be no fun, because I wouldn't be nearly as foolish as I am when I do it just cold without any research. Another Walter Wanderley album. It's a fancy cover. This must be a later one. I'm still looking forward to listening to it. Brazilian organist, good, terrific space age stuff. Peter Drake, steel guitar, and apparently he sings. Of the Darkness, Friend and Lover, apparently this is a one-hit wonder group. Perez Prado, I don't have this record, Happy Mambo, but now I do, Happy Mambo, great cover. Higher Than Phi. Marty Gold, Higher Than Phi. It's a Bossa Nova World. Brooke Benton sings blues favorites with Bruce Darnell Jazz Orchestra on Palace. Really, budget Palace. Records I find on Palace really leave a lot to be desired. But this could be wacky weird. I don't know. Jackie Gleason album. I've got this one, Bad Habits cover, fabulous cover. Now I have another very clean copy. This is a curious record. From a ghetto gang leader to the pulpit, Ricky Engel story. This is a story about apparently this guy, Rick Engel. Look at him. He's radical, man. He belonged to a gang, apparently, and then he found the Lord, and now he's an evangelist. Pat Suzuki on Vic with Henry Renee. That's a lovely cover, isn't it? Also lovely cover, Keely Smith. I don't know anything about her, but there she is. I probably shouldn't have told the bedbug story. That's going to creep some of you totally out. Total creepiness. Terry Snyder, Footlight Percussion. I've got some Terry Snyder stuff, but I don't think I have this one. I'm pretty sure I don't recognize that cover, so I don't know what to expect. And last but not least, at the bug-infested Goodwill, I couldn't believe this was still there. After the weird, wacky, crazy record collector went through it, he passed up Aphrodisia and Mark Denny album. I do not believe I have this. If I do, I got another copy. I was very happy to get it, to get Aphrodisia. And probably, I'm going to play a song from it, I'm pretty sure. It's by the Tiki Drummer. Jabba. Jabba. Jabba Wabba. Bunga Junga Bunga Lunga Dum. 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 Bunga lunga dum, bunga jungle bunga lunga dum, bunga jungle bunga.